Grazie Presidente Gualtieri, Presidente Draghi, benvenuto un'altra volta al Parlamento europeo.
Welcome again,
I have
President
a question
Draghi
regarding transparency.
Since
June 2016, the European Central Bank has purchased more than 75 billion euros of bonds from private corporations under its corporate sector purchase program. I always have had doubts over this program. I'm afraid we are distorting competition among Eurozone enterprises. Moreover, the lack of transparency makes it even worse. At least in Germany, we have a best practice of the Bundesbank publishing the names of the companies, but it is not the case of some central banks in the south of the Eurozone. So not even it is very difficult to know which company's debt is being purchased, but the volumes are not published in an adequate way. This is why, together with so many MEPs of this committee, we have asked the ECB for clarifications of this program through a written questions that we sent you 2 weeks ago. So in our opinion, this lack of transparency at national central bank level is harming the ECB. And it is a pity, as the ECB has made great strides towards more transparency. For instance, the publication of the minutes of the Governing Council or the publication of the target 2 balances that I myself have been defending for years in this House has shown that the more transparency there is, the stronger the ECB becomes in front of the public. So my question is the ECB going to put up guidelines to ensure more transparency at national central bank level in the CSPP? Thank you very much.
Thank you. You will get a written answer to your question, of course, as there was a written question. But let me say just a few things at this stage. We have 6 national central banks that undertake, that are part of this program. And they do publish a list of CSPP holdings available for securities lending. Interested market participants can obtain necessary information by looking at the data published by the NCBs with market data providers and also on the ECB's website. An online database search can be performed for each of these, and among other information, the search will also return the bonds issuer and its residence. Each purchasing national central bank has discretion to decide whether it will publish any additional information in addition to the bonds ISINs on its website. So it's not so much in our hands, it's in the hands of national central banks. But we are of the view that the information provided by the NCBs is sufficient, and we see no reason to try to centralize the publication, which certainly right now is completely in the hands of national central banks. You'll get further responses in our written response.
Time for a follow-up, yes.
Yes, I have 2 minutes. Dear President Draghi, without enough transparency, I think that we have the danger that monetary policy is misused by certain central banks to fit crony capitalism. For instance, the main important newspaper in Spain, Expansion, published that there were rumors that only 3 big companies in Spain had received more than 50% of all the purchases done in Spain. So I think that we should have this information concentrated at the ECB level from all national central banks, because if not, we are doing business as usual, and it is very difficult for us to justify this in front of our electorate. What is the market discipline in this sense? Or we are feeding companies that are not viable in the markets?
Well, let me reassure you that the companies are being chosen on the basis of risk eligibility criteria. That there isn't any intention to favor one company or another. And there are certain guidelines, and of course there are volumes that are being decided by the purchasing banks together with the ECB. But we are not going to disclose the guidelines or to disclose the volumes, because you would simply foster activity by market participants which could actually hamper the achievement of our objectives.
When we'll finish this program?
Now the time is over, but
it's not foreseen. It's just part of the ongoing program. It's like what I said before. It's part of our monetary policy stance. So it will be decided by the Governing Council.